For today's video, we'll be taking a look at AMD's top-of-the-line Zen 5 gaming processor offering, the Ryzen 9 9950X3D. We'll go through the specs for the 9950X3D and run some benchmarks to see how it performs. Let's get started. In terms of specs, the 9950X3D, like its predecessor, is a 16-core part with 32 threads, with the key differences being that the 9950X3D is built on the Zen 5 architecture and utilizes AMD's new 2nd-gen 3D V-Cache technology, where as per the animation on the screen, the said 3D V-Cache sits beneath the Zen 5 CCD. This is in contrast to the previous generation X3D parts, where the 3D V-Cache is layered on top of the CCD. With the 3D V-Cache being located beneath the CCD, the 9950X3D's core complex is now better able to interface with the processor's cooler, thereby paving the way for better cooling performance and full overclockability. It's worth highlighting that while the 9950X3D has two CCXs, only one of the CCXs has 3D V-Cache. Moving on, as can be seen on the screen, the 9950X3D has a 5.7GHz boost clock and a 4.3GHz base clock. This means it has the same boost clock and a 100MHz bump in base clock over the 7950X3D. The 9950X3D has the same amount of L2 and L3 cache as its predecessor, but offers more L1 cache, 1280KB versus 1024KB with the 7950X3D. That said, it's worth pointing out that the TJ max for the 9950X3D is now 95 degrees Celsius, as opposed to the 7950X3D's TJ max of 89 degrees Celsius. Finally, the 9950X3D comes with a TDP of 170 watts versus the 7950X3D's TDP of 120 watts. And with that, let's get on with benchmarking the 9950X3D. To put the 9950X3D through its paces, I've set up a test bench with the following specs that can be seen on the screen. For the purposes of benchmarking the 9950X3D, we've got everything on stock vanilla settings. That means no curve optimizer, PBO, whatsoever. We do of course have Expo enabled on the DDR5 6000 CL28 memory modules by G-Skill, and resizable BAR switched on as well. In terms of OS, I'm using Windows 11 Pro 24H2 with all the latest updates and drivers installed as of the time of publishing this video, and VBS enabled too. In terms of benchmarks, I'll be testing the productivity performance of the 9950X3D using 7-Zip's compression and decompression benchmark test, Cinebench R23 and Cinebench 2024, as well as the Corona 10 benchmark. To get a brief flavor of gaming performance, I'll also be testing the gaming prowess of the 9950X3D using a suite of 4 in-game benchmark tests with a RTX 4090 GPU at 1080p high settings. We've got Black Myth Wukong, Cyberpunk 2077, F1 23, as well as Shadow of the Tomb Raider. On a side note, if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. With that, let's get started. To kick things off, let's take a quick look at the clock behavior, thermal performance, and power consumption of the 9950X3D when under an all-core workload. While running Cinebench 2024's multi-core test, the 9950X3D ran at around 5GHz across all cores, achieving an average temperature of 80.6 degrees Celsius, a low of 75.1 degrees Celsius, and a high of 81.8 degrees Celsius, all while achieving around 197.7 watts of power draw on average when looking at the CPU package power metric via Hardware Info 64. Just as a reminder, these results were achieved while using a Thermalright Phantom Spirit 120SE ARGB CPU air cooler in a non-air conditioned room with an ambient temperature of around 29 degrees Celsius. And with that, let's take a look at the 7-Zip compression and decompression test results, where we get a pretty solid set of results, I'd say, with an overall score of 244.508 jips, meaning that it beats out the 7950X3D and even the Intel Core Ultra 285K, at least from the 7-zip results that I've seen on the web for these two processors. Moving on to Cinebench R23, we see that the 9950X3D attains a multi-core score of 41,690 and a single-core score of 2,256. With Cinebench 2024, the 9950X3D achieves a multi-core score of 2,380 points and a single-core score of 138. Rounding off this section on productivity benchmarks, the 9950X3D achieves a score of 15,361,284 rays per second with the Corona 10 benchmark. For gaming benchmarks, first up, we've got the Blacksmith Wukong Benchmark 2, where with a RTX 1490, the 9950X3D attains an average FPS of 145, a minimum FPS of 110, and a maximum FPS of 172. Moving on to Cyberpunk 2077's in-game Benchmark 2, the 9950X3D attains an average FPS of 249.88, a minimum FPS of 185.35, and a maximum FPS of 297.42. With F123's in-game benchmark test, we see that the test bench achieves an average FPS of 462, a minimum FPS of 366, and a maximum FPS of 519. Finally, rounding off this section on gaming benchmarks, we get an average FPS of 387 when it comes to Shadow of the Tomb Raider's in-game benchmark. And with that, due to time constraints, I wasn't able to test the 9950X3D with as wide a variety of benchmark tests, but from this small sample of productivity and gaming benchmarks, the 9950X3D does come across as a rather promising product offering with great gaming and productivity performance, where it'll definitely give the Intel Core Ultra 285K a run for its money, especially in the gaming department, at least when comparing these initial results against 285K benchmark data that can be found on the web. In terms of pricing, AMD's announced that the 9950X3D will have a MSRP of $699. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.